From the banks of the Ohio River, there's a look at Paul Brown Stadium here in Cincinnati, Ohio. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Cleveland Browns and the Cincinnati Bengals. It's the final 3 weeks of the season. Still plenty to play for here as we're underway in week 15. Gets fielded in the end zone. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Defensively here, you're facing a top 5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
Escaping the pressure right. And he's out of bounds, able to take this one up to the 35. Give him 7 on the tuck and run, and it'll get him a new set of downs.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
Now they'll run it on the toss. This one across the 45 before he's brought down. It's a gain of 13, and the Bengals have a first down. A lot of running backs, a little bit of a disadvantage when you start talking MVP. Might not be the case this year. You think he's got a shot, don't you?
I do. I think he's got more than a shot. But what he's going to need here down the stretch this late in the season, he needs that big closing game, that game that we're all going to reflect on and go, oh, my goodness, did he put up a number, let's say 200-plus?
Right back to him on first down. And he's going to take this one down inside the 45. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on 2nd and short.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last 4 plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, 4 plays in this drive, all 4 on the ground. Switch it up here and look to throw. To the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. A good pickup there, a 22.
Late in the season now, MVP chatter starts, and he might be on the fringe. This is always an award that goes quarterback or running back.
He's against him.
Not a bias. Does he deserve consideration?
He more than deserves consideration because the way the game is played in the NFL now, it's a pass-first league, right? So that means that people are going to adjust their defenses for him each and every week, and he's still putting up big-time numbers. I know the quarterbacks and running backs get it, but he should be firmly in the race for MVP.
Set up 3rd down.
Count me as a little bit surprised by what we just saw there because this has been a pretty long drive, and normally you think that wears down a defense. In this case, looked like the offensive line let them down a little bit.
Yeah, allowed the penetration and the ability to stuff them for a loss. The 7th play now of this opening drive. This is 3rd and long, though.
Flex round!
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw.
Got a man. It's Ross. Complete. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. That's the number two receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage, and tell you what, a few more plays like that, he won't be number two for long.
Able to get in there, he was. And they'll keep possession of the football.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that watched it to get it back. Because this is a quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. And usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Driven it down the field nicely here on the opening drive, and now it's put up or shut up.
No doubt about it, because to make that type of a drive and ultimately kick a field goal would feel very disappointing. But I'm just wondering, is the head coach thinking, is this four down territory? Might he go for it?
Well, they've gotten it to the four on this opening drive, but now they face a third and goal.
Ohio!
Looking to throw. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Bengals take it right down and score on the opening drive. Extra point good by Aguayo. And it's now a 7-0 game. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone.
Position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big body guys in the middle of this day, has got to be priority one.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Chance to really seize early momentum.
Feels to me like they had a really excellent week of practice. It all came together, but I'll bet you it got galvanized in the locker room and pregame. Somehow I think the head coach, his oratorical skills were on point.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. That'll be a loss of 4 yards on the play. And it'll bring up a second and 14. Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gauden, and it's the Bengals with a football to begin quarter number two, but they face a second and long to start things out.
They look to throw. And he'll be hit from behind and taken down. Miles Garrett in there to get him. And that is sack number 15 for him on the year. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and
flex
very
round,
long.
Flex round!
Cut! It's set up to throw. Got that time. Oh, may have gotten lucky. Tried to dump it off underneath on the check down. Nearly picked. Instead, it's incomplete.
How about this offense already feeling good about themselves with a touchdown already in their first drive? They've certainly come out firing, even though that one was incomplete.
With the 7-0 lead, more apt to take a shot like that downfield?
Hey, you're one to the good. Go ahead and try and press your advantage.
So on fourth down, kicking it away here, Michael Pilardi. This is taken at about the 14. Kicked his coverage there. 48-yard punt, but 10 on the return. And the Browns will take over, first and 10. The Browns offense heading back out to take possession. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just
right,
something
now,
to build
56.
Off of. That's
lucky
what they're
56.
Looking for here. The fourth down run successful. Now
go
they look
on,
to pay it off on
go
first
on.
Down.
No. Check. Patriot.
And on the ground they go. They're running back. And he'll take it ahead to the 28-yard line. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
Gone! Back down to that Philly. Here we go.
And they go ground game here with a tailback. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So he was holding from that left tackle position.
Everyone tries to keep their hands inside when they're blocking ever since they liberalized the rules where you can extend them out. But sometimes they get out a little wide and they get detected grabbing some cloth.
Now they face a second and long following the holding penalty. The 20, but only to about the 22-yard line. Brendan Langley there to get him down.
Some of these play calls, I think they're a little conservative, but you know me, because it's easy to sit up in this booth, right, and make all the calls and think I'm going to be correct. But I would like to see them open things up, because otherwise this defense is going to gang up on the run and set them down.
Field position from the 34 now. Here's first and 10.
Here we go.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And they'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. It's a gain of 13, and the Bengals have a first down.
Bay does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
Running game, making them stick with it on first down. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. Call it a loss of two on the play. And that'll make it second and 12.
Came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. Now the Bengals on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This is third down and 12.
Sets up a first and goal. They've made goal line offense a priority on the practice field this week. This is exactly the situation they've been prepping for. They'll give it to Mixon. And they'll get him down here at about the 5-yard line. Only a yard that time, second and goal. Now a timeout called defensively by the Browns. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. The line of scrimmage, once again the 5 as they get ready for second and goal. This will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And the Browns getting set to go. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does. And a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game. And typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down 2 touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. At least 3 points, get that 0 off the board. Throwing here on first down. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. Give him 6 on the play, and it'll make it a second down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
Detroit! Detroit!
They'll look to throw here.
Get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here.
Watch it now,
only 3
Marty,
yards
Marty
on the catch. It's third down. And they'll go with a run attack here. And he'll get this only up to about the 35.
1:59 to go in the first half. We'll come back to Cincinnati after this.
So in their own territory, but they only need a few inches, so they're going to opt to go for this thing. We'll see. Maybe a surprise pass, a run. What will they do? We're about to find out. Fourth down. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. They only needed a few inches, but still some anxious moments there, but they do convert on fourth. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Tackled. It's a gain of 10, and the Browns are going to get a first down. Timeout here as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10.
Gone, 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 gone. Detroit, Detroit. Gone, 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 gone.
They look to throw it on first and 10. Complete. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. It's a 4-yard pickup, and that'll make it a second down.
Gone, gone! Gone, gone! Gone, gone! Gone, gone! Gone, gone! Gone, gone!
They'll look to throw. Shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56. Detroit! Detroit! All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56. Detroit! Detroit!
They'll look to throw here on first down. Forced out to his left. He's taken down. Trying to do a little too much. Getting outside of the pocket. And it results in a sack. Sacks a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. So we've reached halftime here in the Queen City, and it's the Bengals leading this one. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone. We now proceed to the start of the second half. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Here's the Browns offense now getting set to start off this third quarter. They come out here with a zero on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, are they upset that the plays weren't working because of execution? Or do they think just they were just bad plays to call? Well, they found out pretty quickly here that they felt like they had something going, they just need to do it a little bit better or not.
We'll find out. I give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
Tough first half for him. Unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
Six. Second and six, just inside the 30.
All right, now, Lucky 56. Lucky 56.
Big yardage there for the Browns, 18.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
Take this up just shy of midfield. Making the play defensively, Carl Lawson. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. And there's a running game here with a running back. Well, nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. It was Jordan Evans making the play defensively. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down.
All right, now, Lucky 56. Lucky 56. All right, now, Lucky 56. Lucky 56.
Ah! On third down, they'll drop the throw. He's got a lock on. He's got it with the 15.
Leopard!
A big play
Leopard
there on third down for the Browns. An even 40 yards.
You know I'm going to lean towards the defender, right? You know I'm going to do that.
Oh, no. Look,
that's a tough situation
look,
for him as I see it. But the truth of the matter is, that ball was not streaking towards him. That little arc on it, he's got to find a way to get his head around and make a play on the football.
Detroit! Detroit!
Gain of three, second down.
You know that old expression, it's not my night? It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. That's the score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there was an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard, you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
The extra point up and good. And that'll make our score 14-7. This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. So here are the Bengals now as they get their first possession of this second half. That last drive, it was a good mix. Run, pass, run, pass. Defense on their toes.
And what really helps out in a big way is when you're doing the run, pass, mix and everything's working, that means that they're guessing wrong every time on defense. They think you're going to pass when you run and vice versa. I would continue that, and when they finally draw a bead on you, maybe you mix it up a little bit with play action.
And will they maintain that balance? Time to find out. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and two. Here's a second and two now from the 33. Stand up and stop it. So here's a first and 10 at the 38.
Flex round!
Flex round! On first down, he'll drop to throw. And the Browns pressure gets to him that time, and he's going to go down. Well, they were coming out of the 4-3 defensively. Pressure coming off that right side from the DN.
And that's the blind side of most quarterbacks. If you're right-handed, that's the side you don't see quite as well. And that's why you rely on your left tackle, maybe your highest-paid offensive lineman, to take care of you. In this situation, that didn't happen.
Now then, after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23. Now they'll throw here. Out of the gun. Stepping up. He's going to keep it. And he'll slide down to avoid the tackle. Give him seven there on the tuck and run, and they're in better shape now for third.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Now the Bengals on third down. They've been good. 3 for 4 thus far. This is third and 16.
Come on, let's go! White 90! White 90!
Back to throw here. In the heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked up by the former first-rounder, Artie Burns. And his guys are going to take over. Browns, good starting field position as they have it first and 10. They're running now. And nowhere really to go there. They'll take this up just shy of midfield. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they were hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease and they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 14 yards, and it's a Cleveland first down. Back now in Cincinnati. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56.
Back to throw now. First down. And a heavy rush, and down he goes. Carl Lawson in there for the 20th time this year as he continues what could be a record-setting season.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56.
And he's going to take it down to about the 35 here. An 8-yard gain, so that gets him halfway there. Now they're left with a third and 8 more.
I know the toss play begins with the guy taking the snap and turn around and tossing it to the runner. But where the real intrigue is, Can they seal the edge, whether it's an offensive tackle or a tight end, in the direction they want to run the football? If they do that, that's the result that you get, that type of a gain. If they don't, oftentimes it's not a very successful play.
The Browns on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This is third and eight. They'll run again out of the gun. Three yards won't be enough here, as that'll bring up fourth down.
Right, now, Lucky 56. Lucky 56. Leppard. Leppard. Detroit. Detroit. Gone. 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 Gone.
And goal, and defensively all they can do is shake their heads. Not only did they allow the conversion, but a big play as well. A looming decision to make on the conversion, down seven, but first things first, they need to score as they come up on first and goal. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Browns touchdown. A great play there, hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Browns are within an extra point of tying this thing up. And now a critical extra point attempt here. Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And partner, we've got a tie game here in the fourth. So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. Gets fielded in the end zone.
So much for the worry about how they would be after losing their lead. What a big-time return to seize the momentum back.
And out now, here come the Bengals. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. A great Monday night to wrap up the week in football. Two division rivals and a great finish ahead as we come up on first and 10. Now Joe Mixon, and he'll get three down to the 34-yard line. Nice job there on the tackle. Keep him to the short gain. And, of course, he got some good news this week. He was named AFC Defensive Player of the Week from last week's effort.
And part of the reason he got that award, because of plays like that. Not every play is spectacular. Not every play is for a loss. Make the plays that are in front of you. Keep it to short gains, and you pile up statistics. Attention to him. Get after the football. He's dropped it the last couple of games.
As big of a play as we've had in this one so far. This is third and three. Chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Browns offense trotting back onto the field. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Second and two now from the 33. And again, it's Chubb. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. There goes a gain of six that time, and it moves the chains as well. And he'll get this out past the 45 to the 47. Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. The Browns on third down, just one for five to this point. Here it's third and two. They'll run for it. Here's Chubb. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line.
The loss of a yard and it brings up four.
They tried to run right into the teeth of the defense on third down, but looked like those teeth were pretty sharp.
They were having absolutely none of it stopped him for a while.
Yeah, couldn't get any leverage up front and move people aside in order to run the ball.
Fourth and three play, we're going to get whistles and a timeout as they stop it prior to what will be an important fourth down. Down seven, and they've got to go for it here on fourth down.
Detroit!
They stop it right at the line of scrimmage. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and that'll be just about all she wrote for this one. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. Now they'll run it on the toss. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. And now the Browns are going to take another timeout as they get the stoppage with just over a minute to go in the game. After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
Now they turn the right side here, and he stopped immediately there. Well, we looked at each other right when he flinched. We knew that that flag was coming.
Yeah, offsides, easy call, mark off the five, and keep it moving.
Following the penalty, it's first and five, and you got to think offensively, all kinds of options.
Ohio!
And he'll be brought down, and that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags. Trailing in the fourth this close of a game, that's a penalty you just can't afford.
It's an absolute killer, and it's one that drives coaches and teammates insane.
The penalty moves him into the red zone here on first and 10. Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break your serve. That way you hold on to it. They got it done, and they feel very good about that victory.
So for Cincinnati, it's a 10th win of the year now as they move to 10-4. And they'll hit the road next week to take on the Baltimore Ravens. Meanwhile, for the Browns, they fall to 8-6 with the loss. And they'll try to get back on the beam next week as they'll head to Tampa to take on the Bucs. So that'll do it. For my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry, I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. It's a win for the Bengals as we say so long from Cincinnati.